Welcome to Gay Key West. We are going to take you to the best gay resorts, bars, and beaches here on this incredible island.
Hey guys, we're two gay expats. I'm Andy.
And I'm Trey. And we just arrived in Gay Key West and are heading to the Island House, which is known as the best gay resort in the world, according to Out Traveler. We're checking in just before one of the wild Sunday pool parties held from 12 to 4, and we are ready to shed these clothes, grab a drink, and enjoy some warm Florida sunshine. Island House is the oldest gay-owned and operated men's resort in the world. For over four decades, gay men have been coming here for the phenomenal weather and friendly hospitality. The resort also has a heated pool, complete with disco ball, a sun deck, 24-hour bar, two hot tubs, a gym, as well as steam and sauna. The Sunday naked pool party is also legendary. We had so much fun at the pool party yesterday. We are now up and ready for a full day of exploring Key West. We are heading to one of my old favorites, Pepe's, for breakfast. Pepe's is always amazing. We are now in Mallory Square, and this is the popular spot for sunset. And we are gonna do a walking tour all down, I think, Whitehead Street to see the Harry S. Truman Winter White House, as well as mile marker zero, and then make our way down to the southernmost point in the US before heading back up on Duval Street and do a little shopping. There's some cute gay shops that I wanted to check out today. As you make your way down Whitehead Street, you'll run into the end of Highway 1 at mile marker zero, so you're definitely going to want to stop and take a photo there. And then continuing on down, you will find the Ernest Hemingway home. It's the most popular tourist attraction in Key West. It is also home to the first swimming pool on the island. Hemingway restored the home and lived here from 1931 to 1939 when he moved to Cuba. After a quick stop at Hemingway's former residence, make your way down to the end of Whitehead Street, where you will find the southernmost point in the continental United States. Definitely have to take the required photo there. What did you hear from the conch train?
We're closer to a foreign country than we are at Walmart.
Yeah, the southernmost point is actually 90 miles from Cuba, but I think we're like 120 something miles from Miami. At the end of Duval Street, you will find South Beach, where famed gay playwright Tennessee Williams swam every morning. He said, "I work everywhere, but I work best here." So Andy just had a really good question. He was asking, why is Key West so gay? Key West has become one of the biggest gay island destinations in the world, partially because Tennessee Williams and his buddy Leonard Bernstein started coming down here to escape the cold back in the 1940s. And then in 1967, one of the gay natives built the very first resort here, Pier House, which is amazing because we used to come here as a kid every year and we would stay at the Pier House. It's a beautiful property at Zero Duval Street. And then in the 70s, things really kicked off. Lots of creatives from the Northeast started coming to Key West. And then in the 80s, people started coming here for a little bit of a different reason. With the AIDS crisis, people were outcasts in their own communities. And so they came here because Key West is so open, it's super liberal, kind of come as you are vibe. And so Key West just blossomed from there, and now it is an absolute mecca for gay men, which we love. Island House also opened back in the 1970s and has been going strong for four decades. It's absolutely incredible. Such a fun resort.
Wow, there is so much history here in Key West. We are standing in front of the origins of the National Weather Service.
There's also the Pan American Airways first office here in Key West. It was the first scheduled international, regularly scheduled international flight from here to Cuba back in 1927.
So Havana,
yeah, that was super exciting. That's now a brewery, so you can go there and have a few drinks. I almost forgot too, I got this amazing shirt yesterday at Graffiti, which is a gay store here on Duval Street, commemorating that first flight on Pan Am to Havana, Cuba. So now we are heading over to Mallory Square to try the famous conch fritters. There are two things you have to try when you're in Key West. One is conch fritters and the other is key lime pie. So we have our conch fritter order and Andy is gonna try his first conch fritter. So if you've never had a conch fritter, they are made with tons of sweet conch meat, also garlic, lime juice, salt and pepper, sweet and hot peppers, flour, and onions, and then they are deep fried to a golden brown. They're absolutely delicious. If you haven't seen a conch shell, they're the beautiful pink shells here. Key West has been known as the Conch Republic, and locals are also known as conchs. And if you move here, I think after 7 years, you then become a freshwater conch. Another popular choice right on Duval is the gay-friendly La Tida. They have an amazing cabaret in the Crystal Room featuring Randy Roberts. Randy Roberts is a staple in Key West as a drag queen and live entertainer. His signature show at La Tida is not to be missed. We especially love his uncanny Cher impersonations. And the show is very interactive with the audience and super fun. Also on Duval, you will find the Rainbow Crossing in front of 801 Bourbon Bar. The upstairs drag show here is also a blast and very interactive. The queens definitely know how to have a good time. We met some new friends at Island House who we had a fun drag show and bar crawl with one night. Across the street is the epicenter of gay nightlife, the New Orleans House and Bourbon Pub, a huge complex here with guest rooms and multiple bars. We enjoy hanging out at the pool bar here. Inside, you will find either dancers or live entertainers nightly. Bourbon Pub is the perfect place to end your nights in Key West. So it is our last day here in Key West. We just checked out at the Island House and put our stuff in a locker for the day. We're just walking around the city, and then we're gonna probably hit the pool for a couple of drinks before we head out later this evening. But the Island House is amazing. It's such a sense of community. What'd you say? There was like no cliques anywhere. We could go up to absolutely everyone and hang out, all ages, all races. It was really inclusive, very accepting place. So we are excited to come back again next year. We definitely wanna come back here and have another amazing trip. If you are planning a trip to Gay Key West, you will most likely fly into Key West International Airport. What's the airport code?
EYW.
EYW. You can hear the planes behind us right now as they're landing. We're here at Higgs Beach. You have a couple of other options to get down to Key West from Miami. You can either take the Key West to Miami shuttle, which we did this time, but I've also driven, so you can rent a car and drive down. It takes around about 3 hours to get down here. You're gonna wanna stay at the Island House, which is the best gay resort by far. It's super fun. They have a nightly happy hour from 5 to 6:30. They give you 4 drinks. It's so fun. You'll meet a lot of the other guests. If Island House is full, check out Alexander's Guest House, which is right across the street. That's another great option. For the best gay dining, we can recommend the Thirsty Mermaid as well as La Tida. We went to La Tida last night for dinner as well as the show. Afterwards, the cabaret show with Randy Roberts. That was a blast. Amazing Cher impersonations. What'd you think?
Well, she actually sung.
Yeah, oh yeah, the voice was incredible.
It's been a while since I've seen a drag queen sing.
Yeah, like, that's true. Everyone lip syncs these days.
It was amazing.
Yeah, and for gay bars, you're gonna wanna check out Bourbon Pub. That is the epicenter of gay nightlife here in Key West. Well, that's it for our trip to Gay Key West. For more on our recommendations here, be sure to check out our website at twogayexpats.com.
Be sure to like and subscribe on YouTube and follow us on social media at twogayexpats.
Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time.